Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to WT Peterson Oval in Fitzroy. It's quite a beautiful day, it's turned out. It was nice and very cloudy this morning, but the sun has come out and it's not hiding anymore. And we're here for the under-16s girls grade 1 grand final between the Whitehorse Colts and the Hawthorne Citizens. The Colts have got the all-yellow strip with the pink socks. And the Citizens are wearing the brown, gold and white strip with the brown and gold socks. So, should be a cracker. There's a big crowd here in Fitzroy, scattered all around the ground. And I'm really looking forward to this one. For the last 45 minutes since the last game concluded, every girl has been pumping themselves up. There's been tunes being played. And all the parents are quite excited to get this contest underway. And it's a pleasure to bring the broadcast to you. Wherever you are around the world, my name's Jaden Adolf from Game Face, and good luck to both teams. And the first quarter's just about to begin. I'm just getting a couple of people off the ground and making sure they're all in their positions. Here we go. Both ruckmen go up, or ruckwomen, sorry. Good work by both teams. The Citizens punched it forward, but the ball's come to a halt, and the umpire says it's my ball, and we'll ball it up. So the Citizens have got Audrey James in the ruck. Good work by both sets of Rovers. And play stopped once more. So we've got Audrey James, number 32, with the red hair, in the ruck. Up against number 15, Talariti. But the Citizens now have the ball. They kick it out onto this wing. Great contest. The Citizens have the ball. But the Colts pressure's great. Good tackle there by Talariti. And the Colts almost away. Audrey James almost picking it up. She's got teammates around her to help. That's just along the boundary line. James tries to get a kick away. The Colts pressure's good. Good kick there by Willis. And the ball will trickle over the boundary line and be a boundary throw-in. First one of the day. And we have 22-minute quarters, or thereabouts. Four of those. And at the end of it, we'll know who the premiers are. Talariti and James in the ruck. Good throw in. Both ruck women do really, really well. Talariti tries to run through a pack and get rid of it, but her teammate in Freeman tries to pick it up, but has pressure behind her. And they're still moving around for the footy. And it's the Citizens' ball. Sasha Carroll plays on. Gets a kick to it. Well done. Almost a mark taken by number 25, Pousty. Gets the handball away. The Colts pressure's great. Willis tries to pick it up. Good work there by Freeman. She gets the handball over to number 8 in Benson, but still congested, and a brilliant tackle there by Knight of Hawthorne. Audrey James, lone soldier in that ruck contest. Good pressure by both teams. Here go the Colts. Good kick. Citizens have numbers. It's a 3v1. And Freeman, Lucy Freeman that is. There's two Freemans, Charlotte and Lucy. And that was Lucy there that got tackled. And that's another ball up. Audrey James against Talariti. No one grabbed it then, but good work by both. And Audrey James sockers it off the ground, and it's a 1v1 contest between Fern Wannan and number 24, Ella Riemann, directly in front of the commentary position. Talariti taps it. Beramus, Talariti gets a boot to it towards their forward line. It bounces into the chest of number 9, Stilvie, as she gets tackled, and the ball will go out of bounds for another boundary throw-in. So, high pressure, high intensity. Good intent by both sides. Taylor Reedy just grabs it and gives the handball off to her teammate. And good pressure there by number 44, Alex Fairchild. The Citizens get a boot to it in their goal direction. Zara Moore alongside Ella Riemann are battling it out with the Colts defenders, and the umpire says, "I'll have it, thanks," and we'll have another boundary throw in. Ball up, my apologies. James and Taylor Reedy punches it forward. Good work by Benson. Taylor Reedy. Evie Lachlan gets a boot to it. Not a bad kick. It bounces past the pack of players, and running onto it now is Lucy Woolhouse. Gives the handball. They're looking for players a little bit backwards just to try and get that quarterback and run on. But the Colts' pressure's good. There they go. Willis will run it over the boundary line. It'll be another boundary throw in with 18 and a half minutes remaining in the first term. And here they go. Once more, Audrey James and Taylor Reedy. Good tap by Taylor Reedy. It bounces past her teammate, Thomas, but the Citizens get it away. James is in there. There goes Willis. Good work by both sets of players. Lucy Freeman gets a boot to it, and it's a good mark taken. And they're going to use the centre of the ground. It's a 2v1. Willis does really, really well. Picks up the ball, gets it on the boot. It will bounce past a couple of Citizens players, but to their advantage. Good contest made there by Kiara Brain. And play comes to a standstill. Taylor Reedy just punches it. Does really well. It's going to be a great contest all day between James and Taylor Reedy, but the Citizens have a bit of space here. Daisy Searby. The Citizens get a boot to it again. Almost a mark taken by Evie Lachlan, but their second and third efforts are great. And the Colts have a few more players around the contest, and finding a boot to it is McIntosh. Play on, do the sits. They're using the middle of the ground now near the cricket pitch, which is a little bit slippery. They take a bounce. Better kick it. Almost a tackle there by Fern Wannan. And the sits are stopped from kicking it forward, but a mark taken by Fern Wannan, and that's Ali. Going to line up and have a shot at goal, it seems. About 35 metres out. Gets touched by the person on the mark. But her second effort's brilliant. She follows it up great. But it's one of her teammates picks it up and gets tackled, and it will be a ball up just on the edge of the goal square. And we've got blood rule, potentially. Yeah, blood rule. So they'll wait for that player to hop off the ground. That's a Riemann. So this will milk a bit of time. I'm not sure who's coming on, but they're coming on quick as they ball it up. Good tap by both. Good kick out of the defensive 50, and a good mark taken, but they play on, do the Colts. That cools their yellow strip. Sasha Carroll will run onto it. She's got two Colts directly behind her. She sockers it and does really well. Has a teammate there to help, but they handball it directly to a Colts player, which was number 25, Thomas. The ball's just hovering on the boundary line, and a great tackle holding the ball, and the Sits now get possession again. So good tackle there by Harriet Garlick, who will kick it to the centre of the ground to a 2v1, almost a mark by Carrick. Criticides? I'm going to get that confirmed at quarter time. My apologies, but mark taken. Lachlan kicks it over towards Pousty, who will play on, take a few steps and kick it inside the forward 50 to a 2-on-1, but intercept mark. The Colts will use that far wing. No mark taken. Good punch by the defender. It's going to be a hotly contested ball all day, it seems. But the Colts now have the run on. Fern Wannan. gets a kick and finds a teammate, and here goes Freeman, Lucy that is, kicks it up in the air towards another one, bounces in the middle of the 50, there's four players going for it, the Colts still pick it up, but the Citizens defenders are doing really, really well, and they've got numbers, and they soccer it onto this closest wing, and they run onto it. Talaridi gets the hands, good kick there, but I don't have a number for number 17, unfortunately, but I will gather that. It's just not on the team sheet, unfortunately. They kick it into the pocket, and it's a good mark taken by Henson. Hallie Henson. Really tight angle. Is she going to have a ping for goal, or we'll see? No, she doesn't. She just goes to the top of the square and does well, and almost a mark there by Sienna Talaridi. And it is a minor score. So the Colts up by point. And they'll play on the sits and make their way out of their defensive 50 pretty well. Fell through the hands. But the sits soccer it forward, and running onto it now is number 34, Carroll. They do well. Good shepherd. It works well. It's inside their forward 50. But the Colts defenders are there quickly and in front of their opponent. It's going to be a hard slog out there for all involved, but it's been fun to watch so far. Oh, here we go. Nah, it's gone over the boundary line. So I thought the Colts were on a little bit of a run there, but they weren't. They got stopped by the boundary line, and it'll be a boundary throw-in directly in front of the sits bench. So we've got 12 and a half minutes remaining in this first quarter in the under-16s grand final. Gets thrown in. Talaridi just grabs it and handballs to a teammate. They're working really well around each stoppage, the Colts. But the sits pressure doesn't let them get clean possession, so it's going to be a great battle. And it'll be another throw up, or ball up, my apologies. Just on the edge of the square. Talaridi and James. James taps it, but the Colts get possession. They snap it into their forward 50 and do really well. No mark by McIntosh, but it falls through the hands of her, and she keeps going. Her second effort's great. She handballs it in front of herself and almost go over the boundary line, but now the Colts have numbers, and it's a good tackle by McIntosh, and she'll get the reward. So, great effort. She'll go back and look for some options forward. It's a great kick to a one-on-one. No mark taken. And they're still battling it out on the edge of the 50. The sits have numbers. There they go. But the Colts intercept it. So a bit of end-to-end. Great work by Talaridi. She just shrugs her opponent off and kicks it pretty deep in the forward line. But will they capitalise here, the Colts? They give the handball off. There's a lot of numbers. They snap towards goal. And it's going to go across the face almost. And it stays in. Stays in, surprisingly. And the sits now have the advantage. It's outside their defensive 50. They'll continue to soccer it along this wing. But the Colts have numbers. Fern Wannan kicks it. Comes off the inside of her boot. Pousty picks it up and gets tackled straight away. And it'll be a stoppage just inside the Colts forward 50. Both ruck women do really, really well there. But the sits get it out. They're going to continue to try and keep it in their end of the ground. They soccer it. Good work by Fairchild, Alex Fairchild, that is. The sits get a bit of space, but the Colts are there to stop them, and Talaridi has possession again. She kicks it inside the forward 50. There's two sits right there, and Pousty takes a good intercept mark and will look to switch. Carroll plays on, finds the boot, does well, kicks it into the middle towards James. It falls through the hands of her. A couple of Colts come running. James makes a really good smother. They slip over on the cricket pitch, does Talaridi. There goes Fern Wannan. She finds a boot to a 2v1. Almost a mark taken. But it's great work by Carroll. And it's a free kick to the Colts for in the back. So it's going to be a 50-metre penalty. Or 25 in this case, but Colts kick it. They have a spare player there, almost. But the six defenders make good work of it. Barnett intercepts it and gets it on the boot, and almost a mark by Freeman. But the Sits now run away with it on that far wing. Takes a bounce. Connects well with the boot. Towards Daisy Searby. She gets almost held and doesn't have the ball in hand and gets tackled. The umpire doesn't see that, and it will now be a ball up on the edge of the 50 on the far flank, just in front of the scoreboard. And who's in the ruck here? Taylor Reedy's making her way over there, but she's not going to be there in time. Both teams are making it hard for one another. It'll be another stoppage just on the edge of the boundary line. And we've got just over 8 minutes remaining in this first term here at WT Peterson Oval, the old Fitzroy Football Club. Taylor Reedy taps it down to the left, and one of her teammates, I couldn't see who that was, does find a boot, but the Sits have numbers and they'll pick it up really, really well. What a pick up, gets tackled straight away, and it's holding the football. So the pressure for both teams is shining big time here in this first quarter. Good mark. Looks like that's Willis. She's like, lead up. Kicks it well. James takes a great mark overhead though. So a couple of intercept marks per team so far. Oh, very brave by Pousty. She runs, she kicks. It's not a bad kick either. It kicks it in front of a teammate, and the Sits have a couple more numbers almost, but the Colts get back quickly. Good work by Madison Freeman. Pousty, almost an intercept mark. It's a 2v1. Good work by Court. She shepherds and they get it inside their forward 50, but a good intercept mark by Taylor Reedy again. And two Colts are here. Good communication. And it's Lucy Freeman. Looks left. Intercept mark almost. The Colts pile the pressure on. Lucy Freeman's there to help out. And play comes to a halt, and it will be a ball up on that far wing, directly in front of the commentary position. So it's James and Taylor Reedy, it seems. It's been a good battle so far today, but Taylor Reedy wins it and kicks it inside their forward 50, almost inside their forward 50, and both sets of players do really well. Athan runs. Can't get past. Good work by the Sits defenders. Both teams are going hard at it and bounces over the top of James. And the Sits get tackled. It'll be a ball up on that far wing once more. Directly in front of the benches. James and Taylor Reedy. James won that one. They get socket on the ground to the Sits advantage, but the Colts defender, number four, which is Asher Fern Wannan, wins it. But can't do too much with it because of the pressure, and play will almost come to a halt again, but the ball's still moving in that little congestion area. Play on, says the umpire. And the Colts now. Taylor Reedy handballs it in front of herself. Does really, really well. Gets a kick away. Kicks it to their advantage. And here they go. Number 9, Stilvey. Number 10, Harris. Tries to find a boot to it, but the Sits put pressure on again. Real end-to-end footy. Good to watch, and still a point the difference to Whitehorse's advantage. So it'll be a ball up. James wins it comfortably. Sits don't have any numbers running towards the, or in front of the football. Good work by Lucy Freeman. Tries to run out of the contest with it, and it will be a ball up. So we've got 5 minutes on the dot remaining in this first quarter. And the sun's shining. Ruck women are nominated. It's Willis and James. Fairchild tries to pick it up, but the pressure's being piled on by Willis. James tries to pick it up, gets tackled straight away. Good work by Harris, Imogen Harris that is. Tries to run away with it, but gets tackled again. Great effort and great intent by both teams as the Colts find their way out. They kick it inside their forward 50. It almost bounces over the top. Pousty gets a boot to it and unfortunately kicks it out of bounds on the full. So the Colts could score. We've got just over 4 minutes remaining. And with the football in hand is Zoe Grace Willis. And it's a great kick to the top of the pack, but intercept mark by Pousty. She's been good today. Second or third intercept mark by her so far. She looks to play on. Kicks it to the wing. It's a nice kick. Came off the boot well. Fell through the hands of a couple of her teammates. Moore gets the handball off and gets it back and can't get a boot to it. Good tackle there by Audrey James. Charlotte Freeman couldn't get rid of it, and it will be a ball up. Taylor Reedy and James again. They both touch it. Running onto it is Heath. Evelyn Heath. Taylor Reedy runs over and past a couple. Kicks it inside 50. It's a nice kick to the pocket and almost a great mark taken. Very close there. It's going to go out of bounds in the pocket, yeah. So a ball in. And we've got just over 3 minutes to go. And the football is like a hot potato at the moment. Both ruck women do really well. The Colts have advantage and more numbers around the contest. And great smother there. Brilliant smother by McIntosh, which causes the ball to go over the boundary line again. So the umpire will throw it in. Good work by both ruck women. And plays come to a halt. Good tackle by Harris. So another stoppage. Taylor Reedy punches it forward. Sits intercept and get tackled straight away by Harris. And they're still moving somehow. And the umpire says, I'll have it, thanks. And we'll reset. Here they go. Taylor Reedy taps it behind. And Willis tried to get there but got sort of held by her opponent, but fairly. The sits get the handball off. It was a handball by number 20 in Moore. Almost tackled there with Charlotte Freeman. She had to get rid of it pretty quickly, and it's a nice tackle. It's going to be a bit fiery, as you'd expect. It is. It's the big dance. It's a big occasion. Taylor Reedy punches it. Running onto that was number 12 in Charlotte Freeman. But a good kick by Fairchild, and it will find its way over the boundary line. Directly in the middle of the ground. So just near the interchange gates on this side of the ground, but there's no benches on this side. But good vision here. It's Taylor Reedy. I can't see the number of the other ruck woman. They both do really, really well. And the pressure's piled on. Almost a kick by Fairchild once more. The pressure's been immense from both teams. They're moving it. The umpire says it's mine. And we've got just under a minute to go. 55 seconds. Good punch by both ruck women. Excuse me. Pousty gets tackled. Could have called for in the back there, but no free kick, and the sits kick it out into the centre of the ground, but Colts have numbers. Taylor Reedy picks it up and kicks it. It's touched. Sits almost take the mark. It falls through the hands, though, unfortunately, and it'll get towards the boundary line, and it'll be a ball up in just a moment. Yep. And applause all round from both sets of supporters, because this first quarter's been great. Good work by Fairchild, and a great mark taken. That's a good kick. And that is the first quarter in the under-16s Yarra Junior Football League Grand Final between the Hawthorn Citizens and Whitehorse Colts. The current scoreboard, Whitehorse 1 behind to Hawthorn 0. And we'll catch you after the quarter time break. But don't forget, in the meantime, get your game face on.
Hi everyone, Helen from Gameface here, and I'm visiting Provins Timber and Hardware today in Clifton Hill. Third generation owned by the Rosenberg family, Provins is where you can come for all your extension and renovation needs.
So my name's Marnie Rosenberg. My brother and I, Jared, run the business here at Provins Minor 10 with our dad, Barry. So my grandfather bought the business in 1966, and now we're third generation, and yeah, we're serving the community, and Provins has been around for over 100 years. We're super lucky. Most of our customers are extremely loyal, so we get return customers all the time. We do get customers who are doing their own renovations, so we do support the local community with DIYs. We are predominantly a trade business, but we love our local community and servicing them for all their flooring, your decking, your cladding, your mouldings, door handles, everything to do with the whole of house. We're running a cat promotion, so all the cat workwear, clothing and accessories. Spend $100 in a transaction and you go into the draw to win a $500 prize pack of boots, clothes, hats, everything. So it's a really good prize and it's running till the 10th of July. I think for us, it's the feedback from the customers that they're watching their son play football on a live stream, and they said, "Oh, I saw you on the live stream." And it's fantastic to see that the community recognises us as a local community business and can see us that we're giving back to the community that we support as well. Get your game face on.
Here at Woodards Manningham, we love supporting our local community. Supporting the Yarra Junior Football League, we give you, the community, the best service possible. We have created a special offer for all our YJFL families. Simply quote YJFL to our property management team and we'll happily give you the first 3 months of your property managed for free. That's right, no management fees for 3 months on your investment property. Call us today, Woodards Manningham, 9842 1188.
Everyone knows Australia has four big banks. But there's another big bank snapping at their heels. It's been around for over 160 years, has 1.9 million customers nationwide who bank in branch, online, or with their mobile app, and is regularly voted one of Australia's most trusted brands. Who is this bank that has everyone's attention? Welcome to Bendigo Bank, the better big bank.
Welcome back to WT Peterson Oval in Fitzroy. We've got the Yarra Junior Football League under 16 girls 1 grand final between Whitehorse Colts and the Hawthorne Citizens. The Colts will be kicking to the left of screen here in the second quarter, and the Citizens will be kicking to the right. And currently, we've got Whitehorse up by 1 point. We've got a 23-minute quarter coming up. Siren sounds. And good ruck contest by both ruck women. And Lucy Freeman tries to run away with it, but gets tackled. And in and under there is Evie Lachlan. And the umpire will take possession of the football once more and ball it up. Only a couple of metres away from the centre circle. And the Citizens find a boot to it. It'll bounce past a couple of players into their forward 50. Tallarity runs onto it, battles it out with James. James tackles and does really, really well. Forward pressure's great. Tries to get a boot to it, gets tackled straight away. And the Colts get it out of their defensive 50, but their Citizens there behind the footy. And they find a teammate inside their forward 50. Good smother, though, by the Colts defender, which was number 21, Garlic. Sorry, not Garlic, my apologies. It's not, yeah, my apologies. That's number 27, Bolt, not 21. As the ball bounces and Pousty handballs it to a teammate. That's a good kick. Sarah Moore misses. And it's now even. One apiece here. So, even football match here at WT Peterson Oval. As the Colts clear it out of their defensive 50 well. And the Citizens swarm as they kick it into the centre of the ground on the cricket pitch, which is nice and slippery. Or not nice and slippery, but good smother. Every player out there is working really, really hard. The intent is there. They know what's at stake. Today's the big dance, and they want it so badly, as you can imagine. As there's a stoppage on the far wing. Umpire balls it up. Both ruck women do well. Citizens have a number behind the ball, but the Colts tackle again, and they'll soccer it towards their goals through the Citizens. Tallarity picks it up, gets the handball off, and tackles her opponent straight away, and the umpire's pinned her for holding the ball as the Colts now have possession. Santa Tallarity looking for options ahead. Connects well with the boot. Just drops short so I can get in the hands of a Citizens player. And it's a free kick to them. And with the footy now is Emma Stilvey. She kicks it nice and long. Top of the pack, no mark taken. Almost a mark taken, though, by Evie Lachlan, who's been pretty lively this game. And she's not giving that football up without a fight. And she was fighting it out with Asher Fern-Wannon. Umpire balls it up. Ball bounces in between all the players there, and that's moving well. And the Colts find a way to get it out of there, and they kick it in towards their goals. And it's a 2v1 contest as the Citizens now try and just get the ball into space away from the goals. Almost kicked by Thomas, but the Citizens defenders hold their own very, very well. They lose possession and pick it up straight away, and their second and third efforts are brilliant. So, but the umpire will say it's my ball. Plays come to a standstill as they'll reset inside the closest pocket up the Colts forward line, and Lucy Freeman gets tackled as soon as she grabs the footy, but she finds a teammate in Stilvey. But the Citizens get a boot to it, and it bounces way over the boundary line. It will be a free kick to the Colts. And with possession of the football now is number 8, Morgan Benson. Comes off the boot well, really well, and almost a mark taken by one of her teammates, and it just bounces around. Handball out. Pousty almost gets a boot to it. It's a brilliant smother by her opponent. as they try and clear it out of the defensive 50, but it's not going to happen without a fight. Good work by Stewart, who gets tackled and pinned for holding the ball, and a brilliant tackle by the Citizens as they move the ball quickly, take a bounce, and they sock it along the ground because they just can't keep it. Good tackle. Asher Fern-Wannan gets tackled. Wannan. And it'll be a ball up just inside the centre square. Asher taps it well. Willis tries to get on the boot, but here goes Sophie McIntosh and gets tackled and pinned for holding the ball. And it was a brilliant tackle by Zoe Grace Willis, who kicks it inside the forward 50, falls through the hands of her teammate, which is Lucy Freeman, and Citizens have a couple more numbers in the Colts as they battle it out for possession, and the umpire will take possession of it now and ball it up. So we've got just under 18 minutes to go in this second term. Lucy Freeman tries to find a boot to it, has a second attempt and can't get it away. Picking it up almost was number 24, Ella Riemann, but she gets tackled as well. And now it's a ball up once more at the top of the 50. It's a fast-paced game. It's end-to-end, and they're not letting him have any chances, either team. As Riemann gets tackled again, and balled up in the same position. Both ruck women do really well. That was Monica Colley. Colts now, Talaridi dodges a couple, runs inside 50, kicks it towards goal. But there's a Citizens defender right there that unfortunately dropped the mark at the last second, and the Citizens are now in a bit of a dash for survival, really, in their defensive 50, and the ball goes over the boundary line for a boundary throw-in. Deep in the Colts forward line. So the umpire will throw it in. People are moving all around the contest. Good contest between both ruckmen. Pousty gives the handball off, and the sits look really good here. They get a boot to it through Moore, but gets intercepted by Talaridi, whose name I've said plenty of times so far today. And it comes off the boot well. It goes to the top of the pack. It's good mark taken. That's Moore. I'm pretty sure that is. She kicks it onto this wing. Drops in a bit of space in the hole, and they'll contest it. It'll go over the boundary line, and it's in the hands of Sarah Pousty. So the umpire will throw it in. What a day for footy here in Fitzroy, as both ruck women battle it out, and they do really well. The Rovers are there to help, but comes to a stop. We've got Monica Colley and Asher Fern-Wannan in the ruck. The Sits get the handball over the top of the pack, and Willis now picks it up, gives the handball off to Talaridi, and James is on a tail. But Talaridi picks it up again, and her second effort's great. Kicks it inside 50, drops short. Here goes Stilvey, kicks it towards goal, and it's a brilliant intercept mark. As the Sits now get a run. Oh no, it comes off the boot a little bit poorly. Lucy Woolhouse couldn't do much with it. Willis is in there, as well as Bianca Court. There'll be a ball up. Fern-Wannan wins the ruck. They get the handball away, the Colts, but there's no Colts where they were handballing it. But that's just, I guess, the intensity of the game is taking over as Willis tackles Colley once more. Colley and Asher Fern-Wannan, my apologies. And another stoppage just on the edge of the square on this closest commentary wing. Colley, Colts punch it. Willis makes it hard for Evie Lachlan to run away with it, and it'll be another ball up. Both ruck women do really well, and they just knock each other over. Another stoppage. So it's a point in the piece, a point apiece, shall I say, here at Fitzroy. Good work by Ala Reiman, who tries to just shrug the tackle off, but two Colts swarm and take her down. Good work by both ruckwomen again. Asha Fern Wannan. Gets the handball off, and there's citizens now surrounding it. Pousty gets the handball off to Moore, who takes a bounce, and she's got a Colt on her tail. She kicks it, and it will roll out of bounds. Unfortunately, Freeman couldn't get there quick enough. Contest. A couple of citizens are there. Pousty tries to pick it up and gets tackled. They did well though. They've done really well. Lachlan gets it on the boot. It bounces past James. Running onto it is Knight. She tackles her opponent. James has got it now. Holds it in. Another ball up just outside the citizens' 50. So, bit of end-to-end football here at Fitzroy so far today. Pousty tries to run onto it, but Lucy Freeman's too quick. Almost a mark by Stewart, but gets tackled straight away by Evie Lachlan. And next to the little mud patch in the middle of the ground, it will be a ball up. Work. Or almost Willis running away with it, but Stewart fends off her opponent and gets a boot to it onto that far wing. And citizens are there. Bianca Court handballs off. They snap it inside the centre of the ground, and the Colts have numbers, and that's Lucy Freeman now with the football. Looks to the right. Can't find a clear teammate. Evelyn Heath's battling it out now. And it will be another ball up on the edge of the 50, so brilliant effort by both teams so far this game. We've got just over 11 minutes to go in this second term, and there's no signs of either team lifting their foot off the pedal. Oh, unfortunately, couldn't get away there. It was Evie Lachlan with the footy, and be another ball up on the edge of the square on that far wing. We've got the best seat in the house in this Heritage Grandstand, and the citizens through Alex Fairchild try and get a boot to it. She has a second effort and tries to do it again, but the Colts find a way to clear it and get it inside their forward 50. Emma Stilvey has a citizen to tackle her, and it's holding the ball, says the umpire, with 10 and a half minutes to go. So the citizens are defending well. Both teams are, really. The citizens kick it in. Almost there. Almost a mark taken, shall I say, and the ball will almost go out of bounds. But the citizens keep it in, and they're going to try and use the football as well as possible and get it forward. But Colts have numbers. Great pressure by the Hawthorne citizens. Brings play to a halt. That'll be a ball up. Good contest between Holly. Okay, so here we go, the Colts. Freeman pops it up. Almost a mark. Good work by Thomas. She kicks it inside their forward 50 for the Colts, and running onto it are a couple of them. They do well. Oh, good smother. You can notice the difference that this is a grand final compared to previous. It's unbelievable, the effort from both sides so far as the citizens kick it out of their defensive 50. But Talaridi bombs it to the top of the square. Great defense by the citizens though. Stilvey tries to get a hand to it, but her opponent says, no, I'm going to put it over the boundary line so we can reset, and they do so. And the umpire will now pick it up and throw it in. Citizens have more numbers around the ball, but doesn't stop the Colts from laying the pressure on as they kick it out of that little congestion area. And here they go. They've got space to run into, do the sits. They find a boot to it. Almost a mark by Harris, but the Colts do well. James picks it up, gets tackled, and gets hotly contested by Morgan Benson. My apologies. Tellerini against Collie. Both sets of on balls are just smashing into each other. Two Colts are there, and it's a good grab by Sarah Bolt. We'll look back and see if she can find some options, and she bombs it. It's a good kick, actually. Woolhouse picks it up and gives the handball off to Alex Fairchild, and Citizens get a boot to it, so it's 2v2. Tallarity gets possession and runs past the couple, gets a boot to it on the top of the 50, and they find it inside their forward 50 to the Colts, but the Citizens are there once more. And play stops for a ball up with 7.5 minutes to go in this second quarter. It's been an unbelievable game so far. Citizens tap it down. Falls through the hands of Riemann. And ball's moving somewhat. It's not moving much, but it's still moving. Oh, the umpire was ready to blow their whistle, but the Citizens get a boot to it. Here they go. They've got space to run into now, Drew Hawthorne. Oh, can't get a boot to it. Almost got pinned, but the umpire said no. Crowd had a lot to say. Harris gets a boot. Here comes Pousty now. Picks it up well. Gets a smothered kick away, but Shroudry jumps on top of it. And the umpire wants possession, so ball up. Collie and Tallarity, and they both contest that really, really well. It's a hot footy. Good work by Benson. It's inside the Colts forward 50, but the Citizens clear it once more into the centre of the ground, but there goes Bolt. The Colts have numbers. They get their hands away, but the Citizens defenders are there once more. And they're going to clear it, and they get a kick away onto the closest wing. But Tallarity's there. We've said her name a few times today. Takes a bounce, takes her opponent on, and kicks it inside their forward 50. A couple of Citizens are there, though, to defend, and they sock it along the ground. Fairchild tries to pick it up. Gets the kick away just in time before she gets tackled. No free kick. Play on, says the umpire. Riemann kicks it towards their forward 50, but the White Horse defenders in front. And that was number 18, Athen. It's being fought really hard for the football on the edge of the 50 as it gets kicked by the Colts and goes out of bounds for a throw-in here on the grandstand side of the ground. That's Collie and Tallarity in the ruck again. Collie taps it down in front. It's a great tap and a great kick. The Colts have numbers once more. Number 17. Fortunately, someone on my team should have to follow that up, but Fern Wannon can't win it. The Citizens have a lot more numbers than the Colts, but Collie gets the kick away. Intercept mark. They use the centre of the ground through the Colts. Good grab by Madison Freeman. Takes a few steps back and looks for options up forward, but an intercept mark. As the Citizens look out on this closest wing. Good punch. They keep battling it out. That's Asher Fern-Wannon. Real end-to-end stuff so far this second quarter. We've got just over 4 minutes remaining. Good tackle by Morgan Benson, and the ball will go over the boundary line. That's a great example of the pressure that's been shown by both sides so far in this grand final. It's Tallarity and Collie. Tallarity gets the hands back over towards Willis, who kicks it inside the forward 50. Almost a mark by McIntosh, but has no luck. Both teams have a lot of numbers around the footy. It's quite congested, but it's still moving around, and Pousty clears it and does really well. Almost a mark taken, but would have been courageous. James gets tackled. That's a brilliant tackle by Sienna Tellariti. The umpire says, no, I want the football. Tellariti and Colley. They both punch it at the same time, and it stays in exactly the same spot, but the Sits now have possession. Mead. Fern. Wannan. And Freeman kicks it, but Colley intercepts, and she kicks it forward. It falls through the hands of Bolt. Here they go. Milo. Mead gets tackled as soon as she even gets the footy. And the ball will come to a standstill once more. And we've got just under 3 minutes to go in this second term and first half. A point apiece. And here go the Sits through Pousty. She kicks it inside their forward 50. But the Citizens have numbers. Bolt runs, gets tackled, and what a tackle! How's the forward pressure from Hawthorne? They're not letting the Colts out without a fight. Here comes James, kicks towards the goals, but the Colts have a player there. It's a great effort by Freya Milo. And here they go again. Good work by Charlotte Freeman as the Colts try and get it out. And it falls through the hands of a couple of players. It will now trickle outside their defensive 50. As James gets tackled straight away. Sorry, that's not James. My apologies. That's Brain. Both ruck women do really well. Willis tries to get the boot away, and it gets smothered and gets pinned for holding the ball. So it's a Citizens ball with a minute and a half to go. Will they score before the halftime siren goes? Sun's shining. It's not a bad kick, actually. Oh, falls to the hands of... There goes James, sockers it towards goal, but the defender's there to stop it. And the umpire will ball it up again. So high pressure. The intense there. Tellariti punches it away, and yeah, they just can't get it out of this 50, but the Colts now do. In a little mud pit. They go well. Shrugs a teammate, an opponent off, shall I say. And they kick it into space through the Colts. They've got heaps of space. They've got a paddock. Good work by Stilvey. And a great mark by Thomas, Holly Thomas, that is. She's taken a few steps back. Is she going to have a shot for goal or look for a teammate? 25 seconds. What's going to happen? That's a great kick. Oh, and a good pack there. Good spoil by the Citizen defenders to stop the Colts from even getting near scoring. And that's pretty much it for the first half of the under 16 girls grand final. The scoreboard changes by a point, one apiece. So we've got a great contest on our hands between Whitehorse and Hawthorne. We'll catch you after the halftime break. And in the meantime, don't forget to get your game face on.
Have you had your team photos done yet? Well, Frankie Photography is the only way to go. Great photos, great designs. Find out how your club can raise money by selling photos online. Check out our website for other great offers such as live premiership posters, end of season awards, tributes and milestones. And gift vouchers are also available.
Hi, Hi everyone, Helen from Gameface here, and I'm visiting Provins Timber and Hardware today in Clifton Hill. Third generation owned by the Rosenberg family, Provins is where you can come for all your extension and renovation needs.
So my name's Marnie Rosenberg. My brother and I, Jared, run the business here at Provins Minor 10 with our dad, Barry. So my grandfather bought the business in 1966, and now we're third generation, and yeah, we're serving the community, and Provins has been around for over 100 years. We're super lucky. Most of our customers are extremely loyal, so we get return customers all the time. We do get customers who are doing their own renovations, so we do support the local community with DIYs. We are predominantly a trade business, but we love our local community and servicing them for all their flooring, your decking, your cladding, your mouldings, door handles, everything to do with the whole of house. We're running a cat promotion, so all the cat workwear, clothing and accessories. Spend $100 in a transaction and you go into the draw to win a $500 prize pack of boots, clothes, hats, everything. So it's a really good prize and it's running till the 10th of July. I think for us, it's the feedback from the customers that they're watching their son play football on a live stream, and they said, oh, I saw you on the live stream. And it's fantastic to see that the community recognises us as a local community business and can see us that we're giving back to the community that we support as well. Get your game face on.
Here at Woodards Manningham, we love supporting our local community. Supporting the Yarra Junior Football League, we give you, the community, the best service possible. We have created a special offer for all our YJFL families. Simply quote YJFL to our property management team and we'll happily give you the first 3 months of your property managed for free. That's right, no management fees for 3 months on your investment property. Call us today, Woodards Manningham, 9842 1188.
Everyone knows Australia has four big banks. But there's another big bank snapping at their heels. It's been around for over 160 years, has 1.9 million customers nationwide who bank in branch, online, or with their mobile app, and is regularly voted one of Australia's most trusted brands. Who is this bank that has everyone's attention? Welcome to Bendigo Bank, the better big bank.
Hi, I'm Nick from Seafood Station. A shop me and my brother opened a couple of months ago in Fairfield Village. We specialise in fresh fish, predominantly local. Yeah, fresh fillets, we do frozen seafoods as well. A lot of fresh crustaceans like prawns, lobsters, and a lot of whole fish as well, locally sourced, so yeah. Look, it's more just for the people to sort of teach them about, obviously, the seafood market, the seafood, the produce we have in Australia. Obviously, it's our business, it's a family generation, about three generation family business, so we've been in the game since 1959. To me and my brother are very passionate about our seafood, and so we like to get the community involved. We've got a broad range, so we're a lot of different species, from Australian, obviously, the seafood. It depends on the week, but usually salmon, flathead are the big buyers, the big sellers, and we try to sort of teach people different things or try different things. It's obviously sustainable as well, to sort of spread out the usage of the different species. Get your game face on.
Hi there, I'm Matthew from Grange Meats Company. I'm the Managing Director here at our new store in Alphington. We specialise in dry aged meat, wagyu meat. We do a lot in the food service industry, a lot of hotels, restaurants. We've got this beautiful shop, retail shop here as well on Grange Road. Our top selling product will probably be a dry aged T-bone or a dry aged tomahawk, and that's beef that's been grown and fattened on our own family farm that we've processed here and dry aged. So our farm, we've got 1,200 acres out in Romsey Range, and we've had that now for about 35 years. I'm now a third generation butcher in this business, so my grandfather started this originally in Fitzroy, and now we've moved to this new premises here in Alphington. It's always good for businesses to give back to the community. It's not all about taking a business. I also played in the YJFL as well, so it is a little bit close to home for me. I'd encourage other small businesses to get involved, is primarily because these sporting clubs, these local clubs, need businesses like myself to support so that they can operate and children can, you know, go have a kick at the footy. It gives your business a lot more exposure as well to people who may not be in your local area. So especially the YJFL, that's pretty much all across Melbourne and even further. So you do get a lot of exposure from it.
Helen here, and I'm at A1 Bakery in Fairfield today with the lovely Steph. And Steph's going to take me through a few of the best-selling products here at A1. Let's have a look at this amazing cabinet.
We have some foldovers over here. So foldovers quite popular here with the cheese chili. I mean, you don't have to get chili. Depends on your spice, you know, your taste buds want. So we've got the foldovers here, which are really popular, but we also have these beautiful pastries here. So you can get it with like one of our salads. So we've got like tabbouleh, fattoush, gluten-free vegan option.
Looks amazing. And what have you got for me to try here? Okay.
We have the pulled lamb foldover with halloumi and some chili sauce. Are you ready?
I am so ready to try this. I've heard a lot about it and I can't wait to get my mouth into this lamb foldover. Do you want to hold the mic, Steph?
Yeah. I bet it. You need two hands for this. Okay. It's quite the feed. A winter warmer. Oh, drum roll, please. Oh, look at that. That was a good bite. Yeah. Oh, yeah, you've got to be careful. There's a lot going on in there. You don't eat this kind of food on the road, you know? How are you feeling?
Lost for words.
Lost for words, everyone. Lost for words. Yeah.
Thank you so much for having us. I'm just going to... I'm done. This is like heaven. Heaven!
So the second half of the under-16s girls grand final is underway, and it's Collie and Talariti in the ruck, and Willis gets tackled straight away and gets pinned for holding the ball. So Freya Milo kicks it inside their forward 50. It falls through the hands of a couple of players and bounces around. Good work by Moore. Still there, Moore. Gets it out just in time. The umpire was looking. James tackles. There goes Pousty, gets the hands away. That was Sasha Carroll. Ball's just on the edge of the boundary line. Carroll gets the hands away again. Going towards the goal. And is it a mark? Has the umpire paid the marker, or is it a boundary throw-in? They're a little bit confused here. They're going to ball it up. So it's James against Talariti. Talariti gets it, and it gets tapped down onto the ground and goes out of bounds. So James and Talariti, same duo as the first half, goes over the back. Talariti grabs it and handballs it to Freeman, and she tries to get it away, but the sits pressure's good. Still bouncing around in that little pack of players, and it's not moving much, and the umpire will blow his whistle for holding the ball. So I couldn't see that because I'm on the wrong angle, but it's Lucy Freeman with possession. It's a good kick to the pack. Good mark taken by Sarah Pousty. She plays on and kicks it to the top of the square almost, but Colts have numbers. Willis picks it up, juggles the ball in her hands and does really well. Kicks it into the middle of the ground, but Hawthorn have a few players behind the ball in McIntosh, and she kicks it straight to Audrey James, who plays on very quickly, gets smothered by Madison Freeman. And Freeman still got it and gets tackled by James, and the umpire will say it's mine. So, good tap by James, but finds a Colts player who gets it on the boot straight away and doesn't wait. It's being fought pretty hard by both sides on the edge of the 50 as Willis gets a boot to it, and now it's going into space. Running onto it now is, I reckon that's Thomas, Holly Thomas. Can't do much with it though, because the pressure from her opposition is immense. Pousty gets a boot. Good mark, almost by number 13, which is, I don't actually have the name, sorry, but the Colts have possession and they'll continue on. The Colts defenders are in front, so they do well. And it's a free kick to the Citizens. No, to the Colts, sorry, my apologies. Gets kicked right up in the air to the top of the pack on this closest wing, and Freeman tries to run onto it, but intercepting that is Daisy Searby. Good tackle by Morgan Benson. The umpire will say it's my ball for a ball up. That's Colley and Talaridi. Colley wins that one, taps it down. No clean possession though. Citizens have a number behind the play. Oh, good punch away there by number 20, which is Moore. Ball still moving around. James takes a ripper mark and goes back and kicks it almost inside 50. But Freeman's there. She sockers along the ground. A little bit of a dangerous kick considering Pousey was about to pick it up, but the Citizens have numbers. And Benson couldn't get rid of it quick enough and gets pinned for holding the ball. So the Colts now want to move it forward and move it forward quickly. It's a 2v1. Freeman almost wins it, but Talaridi's there to assist. She keeps going and does really well. Kicks it inside the forward 50 towards the goal square to a bit of a pack, and it goes behind and on the boot. Oh, almost. Emma Stilvey hits the post. They play on through Hawthorn and clear it outside their defensive 50. Good mark. Play on, says the umpire. They get a boot to it on that far wing and it's almost out of bounds. No, they keep it in somehow. They continue to battle it out. Now the Colts have possession. It's a bit of a scramble. Every player that tries to pick up the ball gets tackled straight away. And it will be a ball up. So we've got 17 and a half minutes remaining in this third term. Whitehorse up by a point. They're still battling it out. Ball's not moving much. Colts have numbers. Willis tries to pick it up. Same with Talaridi, but every kick that's being made is getting smothered, and every player that picks up the ball is getting slammed. But the Citizens get a boot to it. The Colts have a couple of players behind the footy, which always helps. Going up, almost is Stilvey, but she runs away and gives the handball over the top. Has a couple of teammates there to help. Thomas gets a boot to it. And the Citizens now clear it. They do well. Bolf can't pick it up. Citizens do well. They juggle it. Colts stop them. Bit of end to end. Immense pressure from both teams. As there's a little bit of rain coming down for the first time today. Can't see it hanging around for too long, hopefully. Colley punches it. But the ball bounces in awkward positions as the Citizens clear it. And now they've got a bit of space to run into, do they? But now Colts swarm, and they do well. Willis has possession. Kicks it inside their forward 50. It'll bounce. Ball's wet now. Stilvey does well. Really well, in fact. And now she's got some assistance. As the ball will almost go out of bounds. And it doesn't still. Willis does well. Gets it on the boot, but it gets smothered straight away by Fairchild. And Willis is trying to run away with it. And the umpire says, I'll have the ball, thanks. Tellerede and Collie. Collie punches it, but Fern Wannan is there. Can't do much with it. Tellerede tries to pick it up. Willis gets a boot to it. Gets touched on its way through. Good work by Freeman. Charlotte, that is. And it will be another ball up just on the edge of the 50. The Colts forward 50. Tellerede and Collie again. They both tap it. Pousty roves really well but gets tackled straight away. And it'll be another ball up. The pressure around each contest is great from both teams. Collie and Tellerede. Collie wins it. And the Citizens now try and sock it along the ground. James tries to pick it up, but it falls through her hands. James is back there. Her second effort was great. She gets a boot to it and kicks it towards their forward 50. Here they go, the Citizens. James almost gets the handball, but picks it up again. Snaps it over her shoulder. It bounces. There they go. Lucy Woolhouse can't do much with it, though, because Asher Fern went and kicks it onto that far wing into space. Pousty, though, she's there. Handball's over the top. She finds a teammate, but the Colts are there to battle it out. Tellerede picks it up very cleanly. Gets bumped and loses the ball, and it's been paid holding the ball. So the Citizens now have the footy, and they're looking to move it forward. A mini torp. Nice mark. Bolt. She looks to the left. She looks to the right. Chooses that far wing. Good mark by... I think that's Tellerede. Yes, it is. That's a great grab. Had two players all over her and said, nope, that's mine. And unfortunately, turns it over. A lone Citizen just standing there on the wing. James takes a cracker on the edge of the 50. Turns around quickly. It's not a bad kick. Over the top. Here they go. It's going towards goal. It's going to go across the face. It's out of bounds. So boundary throwing in Hawthorne's forward, or deep forward line. As all the players make their way over there for the contest. Sasha Carroll's in the ruck for the first time today against Tellerede, but she does really well. Handball's backwards to James, who gets a boot to it. Oh, almost a mark taken, but it's a bit of a battle in the goal square for possession. The goal umpire signals a touched behind. So two apiece with just over 12 minutes to go in this third term. And the Colts play on. They get it out of the defensive 50 well. Almost a mark by Benson. Has a couple of teammates to help her and they clear it out. Pousty picks it up. Does well, but has a lot of Colts around her. And the pressure from the Colts has been great. They continue on their merry way down this wing. Good work by the Citizens. They decide just to halt play. So we've got Collie against... Here they go. She punches it forward. Good pressure by the Colts. They don't let Benson go anywhere. Collie's alone in the ruck. Taps it down to Pousty. She does all right, but unfortunately can't get clean possession. But she redeems herself and does it again. Gets it on the boot towards a couple of players on this wing. Zara Moore against Willis. Moore does well. Gets a boot to it and gets tackled straight away, as does Fairchild. And they move the ball forward. But every one-on-one contest has been great. Good effort by Erica Athen, who stops it. And the umpire will ball it up. So Colley and Tellerini again. Good punch by both. Freeman almost gets a boot to it. Umpire says play on. And it'll be another boundary. Oh, not boundary, sorry. It will be a ball up. Good tap by both. Good work by Fairchild to get it on the boot. It's inside the sits, forward 50. Good smother there. And the ball will go out of bounds. And that was a great effort by Madison Freeman. Had two citizens on her and held her own and smothered that kick to stop them from going anywhere. Great defense. Colley and Tellerini ballot out again. Good work by Emma Stilvey. Gets a boot to it and falls through the hands of Bianca Court. There goes Moore. But a great intercept mark. So the Colts looking for options. Oh, almost. Almost. Pousty. Fairchild kicks it inside the forward 50. It connected with the boot really well. James battles it out, but the Colts clear it now, and there's 3v1. Thomas is making her way over there to help out, as is Shradri. But the sits to soccer it onto that far wing and try and find some space and get it out of their defensive half. They continue to do so as it sits on the boundary line and will now go out of bounds. So pretty much directly in front of us in the grandstand, there is a boundary throw in on the far wing. That's Colley and Tellerini in the ruck. Colley just punches it forward, or sorry, back, because there's a lot of citizens behind the ball. They continue on forward, but the Colts have numbers. Almost got away with it there. It was Asher Fern-Wennan. The ball's come to a standstill again, and the umpire said it's my ball. We've got just over 8 minutes to go in this third quarter. Still 2 points apiece. It's been a great game to watch. The pressure's been unreal from both teams, and as Tellerini just boots it into their forward 50, good battle between each player, or each pair of players, and the citizens don't let it go any further deep into their forward line. Just inside the Colts forward 50. Tellerini and Colley battle it out. Colley wins it really well. Good kick away by Evie Lachlan, but she finds Willis for the Colts. He'll kick it over towards Bolt, but misses Bolt. Couple of citizens sock it along the ground, and now they've got space in front of them. Good shepherd there by Moore. She does really well. Lachlan finds a teammate. And now they're looking for options. Moore's out here on the left, but no, they're going to use that far wing. Good work by Alex Fairchild into the middle of the ground, but oh, bit of a rough contest in that little mud pit. Now they're on the cricket pitch. They'll have to take it easy, but here they go. Tellerini just bombs it forward. That's nice. Sockers it. Or is it Maddie Coleman? Sorry, I can't distinguish the difference between the six and the five, but the Colts continue on, and it's a ball up. So not a heap of scoring opportunities this game, and the reason why is because each team is going hard at it. Still doing so with just over 6 minutes remaining in this third term. Both ruck women go at it again. Colley holds her own really well against Tellerini, but there go the citizens. They kick it into space. James almost wins it. She does well, keeps her feet, unlike her opponent. She does well again. Gets possession, but now the Colts have it. Quick little turnovers in those little congestion areas from both teams, which makes it interesting. And the umpire says it's my ball, even though the crowd said otherwise. There they go. Colley does well, handballs it out, finds some space, and now the Citizens get on a roll, but Bolt almost takes the mark. Here they go. Oh, almost high contact, but it was accidental as the Colts defenders hold their own. And we've got 5 minutes to go in this third quarter. We've got one more game after this one here at WT Peterson Reserve. As Pousty kicks it towards goal, and it's a behind. But gives her team the lead by a point with 5 minutes remaining. Great contest between both teams. As the Colts now have possession and will be looking at clearing it out of their defensive 50. They do well. They use that far side, which has been used a lot today. But James almost takes a screamer. It gets spoiled, and now it's a bit of a battle for the ball, and the umpire says it's mine again. That would have been an absolutely cracking mark if she was able to hold on to that, but good effort. Good work by both ruck women. They battle it out really well again. Freeman tries to get it out. Lachlan tries to get a boot to it. It gets smothered. Just the pressure around the football. It's unreal. Unreal by both teams. Cannot question their intent whatsoever. Freeman kicks it out. Now it's at the top of the 50. The Citizens have numbers. Pousty just runs through a group of them. But the Colts now, they'll run. They'll get it onto the wing. It's going to be a good battle for the football. Oh, good work there by Evie Lachlan. Oh, Asha Fern went and kicks it inside their forward 50. And it's a great grab. Great grab by Sophie McIntosh, who plays on, takes a bounce and gathers the ball again. Kicks it over towards her teammate in number 44, Alex Fairchild. But James is getting involved now. She gets a boot to it. Good intercept mark, though. Unfortunately, I can't see the number on the player's jumper, but they do continue on. Both teams are going hard at it. This is so good to watch. Obviously, it's anyone's game with a point in it, and we've got 3 minutes to go in this third term, and then we've got another 23 minutes. So, not long left to decide the under-16 girls' premier. Talaridi punches it down. Pousty's there, as always, and picks it up pretty cleanly and gets tackled straight away. The umpire will say, play on. I thought he was going to blow his whistle, but he does say play on, and as the ball's almost out of bounds, they do continue on battling it out for the football, and both teams, the Colts get cleared. It's on that far wing. Here goes Evelyn Heath. She does really, really well considering, and she gets it on the boot somehow. She has teammates there to help, and they get tackled straight away by their opponent, and the umpire says, I'll have it back, thanks. So I think it's Colley and Talaridi once more. But as soon as anyone grabs it, they get tackled straight away. Obviously shows how much this game means to each player, but the Colts do get a free kick for holding the ball, and that's through number 3, Ali Fern-Wennan. And they paid a 25-metre penalty. So, a bit of undiscipline there by the Citizens, but they are up by a point. A minute 35 remaining. Good contest and a great mark by Alex Fairchild, who kicks onto that far wing. There's a couple of plays there. They try and run onto it, and they do really, really well. Kick it towards their forward 50. Here they go. They could score here and get something before free quarter time. But Imogen Harris is in the way. Pousty gets tackled, gets the hands away. Umpire says, nope, play on. has the pressure. Fairchild kicks it, but the Colts defenders are there. Harris gets tackled, gives the hands off to Asha Fernwennen. Or Wannan, sorry, Wannan. It trickles past Freeman. And now the Colts just take it easy with 40 seconds to go. Tellerede. That's not a bad kick over to Lucy Freeman, but just a little bit too high. They continue on, and it's high contact, and it is a free kick. So, well umpired there. We've got 22 seconds remaining in this third quarter. What a contest we've got on our hands. What a last quarter coming up. Point the difference. Hawthorn up here at W.T. Peterson Oval. And that pretty much seals the third quarter. That is it. So it is three-quarter time here in Fitzroy, and we've got a huge fourth quarter on our hands. Current scoreline, Whitehorse Colts two behinds to Hawthorn Citizens three behinds. And we'll catch you after the three-quarter time break. In the meantime, don't forget to get your game face on. The final term of the under 16 girls grand final here at Fitzroy. Taylor Reedy just punches it forward and does really well. The Colts kick it in towards their forward line. Almost a mark taken. Good work by the Colts. And it's a snap by Emma Stilvey. And she misses. So, 3 points apiece. Only about 30 seconds into the quarter. As the Citizens look to move it forward now. They kick it onto this wing or into this flank. Pousty does well. Gets tackled almost in the back. It is. And that's against Lucy Freeman. So Pousty will take a couple of steps back and look for options on this wing. There's no one really looking to switch, but she just roosts it forward. And the ball will be punched and tapped out of bounds. So the umpire will throw it in. Good work by Collie. The Colts soccer it off the ground. Alex Fairchild tries to pick it up and get it on the boot. Does it again. Handball's out. Moore gets a boot to it. It bounces. Work by Madison Freeman. James gets a little bit of a boot to it and moves the ball forward. But Colts players are there. Goes number 17, which is, I don't have the name. Unfortunately, no one was able to supply me that. But the ball will roll out of bounds for a boundary throw-in once more. And what a great grand final this has been. Both teams going hard at it all day. 23-minute quarters. It's a hard slog and never cease to amaze. Collie and Tallarini. Tallarini punches it forward and she starts a couple of metres away. On the boot there is Imogen Harris and intercepted by number 34, Sasha Carroll. But now Zoe Grace Willis tries to get it on the boot and unfortunately doesn't go as far as what she would have liked. And now it's in the centre of the ground. The Citizens get a boot to it. A couple of Colts there. It bounces awkwardly and there's players surrounding the football. Good work by Thomas. Gets tackled and pinned for holding the ball. So both teams' pressure is up so far this quarter. Pousty said her name a lot today. She's been really, really good. And she kicks it really, really well towards a couple of teammates along the boundary line. But they can't keep it in and the umpire says it's fine for a boundary throw-in. So here they go. Collie. Tellery starts a couple of metres away so she can just run in and punch it. Pousty tries to pick it up. She does well and gets tackled straight away. Gets the hands off though and Juliet Mead just can't get a boot to it. James versus Asher Fern-Wannon. Work by both sides. Pressure's on. And a great tackle by Maddie Coleman. Forward pressure. That's what it's all about. James and Tallarini. Tallarini wins that one and then grabs it herself and kicks it herself and finds a teammate in Thomas who kicks it pretty quickly into some space in between two packs of two. Citizens now have the football. They get it on the boot and it bounces right in front of a pack. Here goes Moore. Handballs over the top towards Pousty. Fortunately didn't find her as well as what they would have liked. Moore now has possession again. She'll go onto her left foot almost, but no, she decides to go the handball. Monica Collie. Now Audrey James. Does well too. Handballs over the top. Here goes Pousty. Kicks it inside the forward 50. Looking lively now, the Citizens. Heading forward pretty quickly. But the Colts pressure once again. They don't have answers. Scores stay level. Just over 18 minutes remaining. Umpire balls it up. Good work by Alex Fairchild to punch it forward, but Colts are there again, and the umpire will have possession of it again. Both ruck women do really well. Pousty almost grabbed possession, but the Citizens, look at them. They're swarming. And there's Pousty again. She's in and under. The umpire will ball it up on the edge of the 50 metre line. Tellerini taps it forward. Moore handballs out into space. Running onto the now is number 32, which is 22, Hansen. But now the Colts have numbers and they get it on the boot pretty quickly. Good mark by Pousty. He's had a few intercept marks today. The mark's got to come back, otherwise it'll be 25. The umpire lets it go. Boosted into the forward 50. No one can take the mark. Colts players try and scramble and handball it out. That's a throw. That's a free kick to the Citizens. So possession of the football now is in the hands of number 22, which is Evie Lachlan. She kicks it towards the goals. Almost a mark taken, but once again, drops at the front of the pack, and getting tackled there is number 12, Charlotte Freeman, for the Colts, and the umpire will ball it up in the Citizens' deep forward line. Almost a winning tap there by Audrey James, but Pousty's there. They tap it out. Here they go. The Colts, though, they have numbers, and Zoe Grace Willis isn't letting the Citizens get anything at all when the ball's in their forward 50. The Colts defenders have been solid all day, as have the Citizens, but there they go. The umpire will pay holding the ball, and the Citizens now have the footy and in the hands of Monica Colley. She's got a big kick on her too, Monica. And she just kicks it up in the middle of the 50. James almost takes it. Fortunately, no luck. But good work by Tala Reedy. Won a seniors premiership only a little while ago. McIntosh kicks it. James retrieves it really well. It bounces. Here they go, the Citizens. They're looking lively, but the Colts have got the answers again. Oh, almost a good mark there by Colley. Now the Colts get a kick away. Looks like that's McIntosh again. Kicks it. Good mark taken. They're moving forward. It's been up this end of the ground most of this quarter so far, with just over 15 minutes to go. Inside their forward 50, Pousty. Great grab. Well done. Sarah Pousty now. This is a big kick. Any score is an advantage. It's not a bad kick either. Top of the square. Oh, the Colts defender sockers it. James is there. Can't get there quick enough, though. Good work by Asher Fern-Wannon. Everyone's got players behind the footy again. Been saying that a lot today. Both teams have been really, really good in regards to setting up behind play. And the umpire says, nah, I'll have it again. Thank you. James taps it down. Citizens get a boot to it. There's a Colts player there. Good mark by Maddie Freeman. She's looking out on that far wing, but she's got a teammate out here in Charlotte Freeman. Oh, that would have hurt. They continue to battle it out. The Citizens now have numbers, and they get a boot to it, but not clearly enough. Oh, almost a sling tackle, but they continue on their merry way. Do both teams fighting for the footy, and the Citizens and Colts still three apiece with 14 minutes to go in this last term in the under 16 girls Yarra Junior Football League grand final. It's on the edge of the Citizens forward 50. Tellerini and Colley. Colley does well and punches it into space, but the Colts have numbers and shrugs them off. Good tackle though. That's holding the ball. Citizens play on. Pousty finds a teammate in Moore, Ella Moore, and she's going to go back and have a shot. And this is probably within her range. She's kicked a couple of times today, not towards goal, but just in general play, and she's definitely got the boot, I think. There's a look at the number of players on the line. There's a lot at stake if she scores here, especially a major. Does well. Oh, hits the post. So the Citizens are up by points. as the Colts will look to bounce back and find a score themselves as they play on out of the back line. There's a lot of space. They kick it onto that far flank. A big lollipop in the air. It works out okay. The Colts now have numbers and Freeman's there. Gets bumped as soon as she kicked it. Excuse me. The Citizens can't get clean possession away. The Colts' pressure's immense. I've said that about both sides all day. All around the ground. And there'll be a stoppage on the 50-metre line with just over 12 minutes to go in this last quarter. And Hawthorn are up by a point. Currently, they are the premiers. But it can change in a matter of seconds. As they continue to battle it out. Great work by Willis. He's in and under for the Colts and he's fighting it out. As the ball's not moving much and the umpire will ball it up again on that far flank. How good's the view from this grandstand with the city in the background? Colley taps it down. Colts player gets it. Sorry, I couldn't see the number, but they do continue on. Now Pousty gets a boot to it, her left foot. Here goes Alex Fairchild. Oh, good smother there by the Colts defender. The pressure is on, and the Colts have numbers. Maddie Freeman couldn't get a clean kick away without it being smothered. It's been a common story all day for both teams. And great work by Zoe Grace Willis, who kicks it out of their defensive 50, but unfortunately turns it over and looks like Monica Colley with the football now. She's got a big kick, and she does really well at kicking that one. Finds the big pack. Alex Fairchild battles it out. It's going towards goal, but it's going across the face. It will be a boundary throw in Hawthorn's deep forward line. And we've got just under 11 minutes remaining in this last quarter. Hawthorn are up by a point. This is the big dance. This is it. 11 minutes left of this season. Whoever wins this lifts that premiership cup at the end of the day. Good work by Fairchild. Slips over though. Both sets of players are going hard at it and have been all day. The Colts aren't making it easy for the Citizens to score and vice versa. Oh, it's gone towards goal, but it's going to be a point. So another behind for the Hawthorn Citizens. As the Colts will look to move it forward quickly. But they'll use that far side again. Wow. That's a great kick. And it's a mark. Pousty. Plays on. Good kick. Middle of the 50. Has a few teammates there. The Citizens have the numbers around the footy. Moore tries to pick it up, but has a Colt player on her tail. And the umpire will ball it up again. There they go. Oh, step towards goal. They've kicked the goal, the Citizens. The first major of the day. Three behinds to 1-5-11 with just over 9 minutes to go in the under 16 girls grand final. That's a great effort. And never gave up. Either did the Colts. As the players reset and make their way to their positions. As the umpire will get ready to ball it up, Monty knows the players are in their positions. Good work by both ruck women. The Colts. The Citizens. There they go. Bill bounces in the mud pit. Freeman. Goes over the top of the pack. Now it's just come to a standstill. At the top of the Colts 50. 8 points the difference with 8 minutes to go. The Citizens have numbers and they try and run it forward, but the Colts say no. But the umpire says I'll ball it up. Colley taps it down. That far wing has been used quite a lot today and they find a way to get on the boot. Pretty sure that was Alex Fairchild that found the boot there, but they continue to work as hard as possible, these Colts players, and they're doing really well. They handball the ball into some space and they tackle their opponent with an immense amount of pressure. As the breeze picks up a little bit more here at WT Peterson Oval, the Colts move the ball forward and it's probably the furthest up the ground the ball's been since the start of the fourth. 7 minutes to go. The Colts kick it to the top of the 50. There's no Colts there though. It's going to be a sprint. They're working really hard. Well done to both sets of players there though. Daisy Searby was not going to make it easy for Asher Fern-Wannan. Stoppage, ball up. Fairchild kicks it onto the closest wing, gets it out of that congestion area and out of their defensive 50. And Moore does really, really well and kicks it in the direction of Lucy Woolhouse. But Colts have a couple more numbers and they do all right. Imogen Harris just can't get a boot to it. James is involved now too. Ethan loses the battle with James and now it's inside their forward 50. The Citizens. Good work by Bolt. She holds her own. Gets tackled. It'll be a ball up inside the Citizens forward 50. We've got just under 6 minutes remaining. It's still anyone's game and the Colts try and clear it as quickly as possible. Fairchild kicks it back at them into their forward pocket. Oh, just missed. So now it's 9 points. They make it ever more difficult for Whitehorse to crawl back and bridge the gap. The Colts look to use this side and it goes over the top of the pack, so there's a lot of space. They continue on. Good tackle there by Imogen Harris on Moore. It's a free kick to the Citizens for kicking in danger. And the ball's in the hands of Alex Fairchild with only 5 minutes to go in this last quarter. There they go. Good work by the Citizens. They're moving the ball into their deep forward line. Bolt shrugs her opponent off and kicks it over the top of all the Citizens players, and running onto it now is Asher Fern-Wannan, but stopping her in her tracks is Searby. The Colts don't have anyone there. It's going to kick to a 2v2. Oh, what a good battle this is. It's in the centre of the ground. And a great tackle by Eve Stewart. But the umpire said no. That's a dangerous tackle. Give the ball to Harriet Garlick. She kicks it onto this wing. Pousty's going to run onto it, but she has someone on her tail. That's Freeman. Can't get rid of it. They continue on. Good tackle by the Colts. Shroudry has possession of the footy. Tries to get it out. Has no luck. And the umpire says, I'll have the ball. Thanks. Colley and Fern-Wannan. Colts kick it forward. The sun's in their eyes. No one could really mark that. Talaridi trying to play her part. She's played a big one all day. As the umpire will stop play once more and throw the ball up on the edge of the Colts 50. Forward 50, that is. Talaridi boots it inside the forward 50. But a great intercept mark by Searby. And a great mark by Pousty, who says to her teammates, lead up the ground. So she kicks it in their direction. That's a good intercept mark there by, I'm pretty sure that's Sarah Bolt. On the boot, top of the 50, and that's an intercept mark. Can't see the player's number, my apologies, but it is a citizens player, and they make it ever so harder for the Colts to crawl back this deficit. But it's a good mark there by number 5, Maddie Freeman. She plays on quickly, tries to find a teammate. Tally Reedy's there. There's a couple of players. Stewart. Someone tries to kick it off the ground. Looked a little bit dangerous. Pousty gets it out. Good mark by Freeman, though. Brilliant mark. Plays on quickly. Kicks it out in front of a couple of different players. Lucy Freeman, who does well. Gets sling tackled. It's a free kick. They've got to move it quickly. 2 minutes to go. 9 points the difference. An intercept mark almost taken as the ball will go over the boundary line. Almost. No, they keep it in. That's surprising. The citizens will be looking for a stoppage here just to milk a little bit more time, but it's almost out of bounds. You couldn't get any closer to the boundary line if you tried. They know what's at stake. Colts get possession and kick it inside their forward 50. Someone's taking a mark. It's a Colts player. Number 15, Tala Reedy. She doesn't muck around. She kicks it deep. Oh, almost a mark taken. A couple of citizens there. Pousty. She's been all over the ground all day. She doesn't know what to do with it, but she just kicks it into space. Both sets of players still going hard at it. Under a minute remaining. Now the citizens run on with it. Great work by Freeman to smother that one. And a great second effort there by the citizens player. Moore and Riemann help each other out. High tackle. Umpire pays it. Bolt's not happy with that. Fair enough. That's 25. Which, unfortunately, tells us what the end result's going to be, considering that the Colts don't have that much time remaining, unfortunately. And it's a boundary throw-in. So, there you go. Under 10 seconds. Hawthorn citizens have done it in the under-16 girls competition. They are premiers. There you have it. Hawthorn Citizens 2022 Yarra Junior Football League Under 16 Girls Premiers. Commiserations to the Colts. It was an absolutely brilliant contest by both teams. But the Citizens have done it. And they will celebrate for days to come. Congratulations. And thank you for joining us on the broadcast today. We look forward to seeing you very, very soon. We'll catch you for the next game. And don't forget to get your game face on. So there'll be a presentation after this, like they did last time. Remember how they had all the people when they did the presentation? When the presentation starts, I'm just going to pan the camera so it films there. Good work, mate. Thanks. That was great. So where's the Zoom, out of curiosity?
The Zoom?
Yeah. That one, that's it.
Hopefully we'll be doing the next one. Yeah,
thanks, man. Yeah.
Thanks,
guys.
Thanks, mate. Enjoy the rest of your weekend.
You too.
mate, be hungry. Awesome.
Thank you.
boxes of John Lewis. Thank you.